Hi, and welcome to our new series on celiac disease and gluten intolerance. I'm your host, Steve Jaccard, and with me today is Renee Colman. She is the president of the Kamloops chapter of the Canadian Celiac Association. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me today.
Renee, you have celiac disease. What is it?
Steve, celiac disease is an intolerance to gluten, a protein found in wheat. If I ingest gluten, I actually do damage to my small intestine, and it affects the way I absorb nutrients and vitamins from the foods I eat.
How common has celiac disease become in Canada?
When you look at the statistics, they say it's one out of every 133 people have celiac disease. In Canada, they suspect there's about 330,000 people who have celiac disease, but out of that number, only 110,000 of them are actually diagnosed. And the incidences of celiac disease over the last 25 years in the Western countries has actually begun to double.
What symptoms might a person with celiac disease experience?
There's a wide variety of symptoms you can experience with celiac disease, but common ones are anemia, bloating, chronic diarrhea, irritability, migraine headaches, and depression.
If a person thinks they might have celiac disease, how would they go about finding out for sure?
You go to your physician and you ask them to run one of the two blood tests that are available, either the EMA or the TTG antibody blood tests. After that, and you've received a positive blood test diagnosis, your next step is to actually have a non-invasive small intestinal biopsy done.
Is celiac curable, or is it a lifelong condition that requires management only?
Currently, celiac disease is not curable, and the only way to manage it is a 100% gluten-free diet, and that means no cheating, ever.
Are there any other conditions or diseases that could be associated with celiac disease?
If you have a family member who has celiac disease and they're a first or second degree relative, it is recommended you go and have yourself tested for celiac disease. But there's other common conditions that go along with it, such as autoimmune thyroid disease, autoimmune hepatitis, infertility, osteoporosis, Down syndrome, and Turner syndrome.
Interesting. Renee, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Well, that's been our first show on our new series on celiac disease and gluten intolerance. Thank you for joining us. If you'd like more information, you can go to www.celiac.ca or www.kamloopscelia.org, or you can call Renee at 250-319-9978. For Shaw TV, I'm Steve Jaccard.